Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. My name is Nealay Patel and I'm the owner, designer, and educator here at SilverSilk and More. And I wanted to talk to you guys today about a very special topic that I feel needs to be covered, especially after so long. I just want to start by saying that SilverSilk is a unique product, but luckily the tools that we'll be using to create all of the different projects in the tutorials are pretty basic. And actually, there's not even that many. And so I just thought I'd take an opportunity to show you guys the tools that I like to use for each of the projects. And there's not going to be any technique or anything crafting involved with today's video. It's just purely to cover the tools that I like to use. And it'll give you guys a reference to where to buy them, what to use them for, because you'll see these tools reoccurring in many of the tutorials. And so it's just a better comprehensive way to kind of cover everything. So I'm just going to flip it down to my work table. And I'm just going to start by going down the list. Importantly, I guess, if you are wanting to purchase any of these tools, you can check out the video description here in this YouTube video. And while you're there, do subscribe to the channel if you can, and tell your friends about this. And then, of course, bookmark this video in case you need some reference material down the road for the tools. All right, let's just go down the list. First is my Lindstrom cutters, which I actually put over there. I'm going to grab them real quick. These get so much use in all of my different applications of using SilverSilk and craft products, and I just love them to pieces. They are extremely sharp. I've had these for nearly 15 years, believe it or not, and they're still holding on very strong, and as you could see with the yellow handles, they've seen better days, but that just tells you how much I use it. I use these babies to cut beading wire, to cut craft wire. I've cut thinner memory wire on occasion, though I don't recommend it with these pliers. And let's see, I've cut thread with them before and they've remained sharp over time. And so I highly recommend these, and they are a little pricey, but they are definitely worth the investment, especially given the fact that I've had these for over 15 years and they're still holding on pretty tight. That just tells you guys that, like, they're worth the investment. And cutters are one of those things that they don't match a set. You could get the Lindstrom set if you want to. It's very expensive and I probably wouldn't recommend it, but definitely the cutters, because they just work for everything. So the link is in the video description, just if you want to check these out. So next is actually my favorite set in the world. It is the Weber's Pro Line set, which I've got so many different tools that I want to show you. Guys, I picked up all five of the Pro Line ones, and I'll just kind of go over them one by one. First is the chain nose pliers. They have a really nice narrow tip, and you can use the wider part to hold simple loops in place while you're wire wrapping the stem. These are just great for just having a set of, I don't know, little pinchers that can kind of get into anywhere and hold things as you need to. I really love the metal handles. They're just kind of coated in this coating. You can see it's kind of wearing off. But again, just because I've had these for a long time and I use them for everything. But I love how ergonomic it is with these little divots for the handles, for your fingers to kind of comfortably move and position themselves into. And I do have a pair that is also bent nose, which looks like this. And use them for quite a bit of, to get into small spaces, really. Mostly I've used these to make simple loops and wire wrap loops, so I will say that. So I love those. And then I've got my wide nose pliers that I definitely want to talk about. These are going to be your best friends when it comes to crimping SilverSilk findings. And there is a process involved with these pliers, and it includes also coating the tips with a product called Tool Magic, which is also in the video description as a link. That's this right here. I recommend you go out and grab this and dip your wide nose pliers in it. The wide nose is really nice for the findings because you can grasp the entire silver silk finding all at once and then give it a good squeeze. Whenever you do squeeze it, the tool magic will protect the coating, or actually the plating that's on the finding. So for example, if you're using a silver single strand end cap or a double strand end cap, you can go in and give it a good squish and it's not going to chip or scratch the finding. And you can kind of be as, you know, I hate to use the word aggressive, I guess. You can give it a pretty good squeeze without without having to worry about anything happening to the finding. I also love that it's sort of rubberized because whenever you grip the finding or really anything that you're picking up off your table, that rubberized coating will grip it really well and it won't slip out. I used to use nylon jaw pliers to crimp my findings, and I found over time that that was extremely problematic, especially if I'm trying to squeeze a finding and then it goes flying across the room, just because the nylon jaw pliers are so smooth and they don't really grip anything. And so another reason to go out and grab Tool Magic is that the grip is just phenomenal. So there's a couple of reasons for that. And yeah, the wide nose again just is a bigger nose that you can use to grab all the way to triple strand end caps without any problems. So recommend having those in your tool box. What else have we got? I covered Tool Magic, and then I haven't done the nylon jaw pliers. Now, I've strictly used these just to straighten out my craft wire, which I have to do on occasion. Most of my craft wire is rolled up, and it gets kinked over time. I stored it in Ziploc bags or in boxes, and I hate throwing away scraps just because I'm a little bit frugal that way. But those scraps come in handy for making small, I don't know, small simple loops, small wire wrap things on the fly. And my nylon jaw pliers are great for straightening out those kinks and getting that wire ready and conditioned and warmed up, ready to be crafted into something. So I recommend having the Weber's brand. They can be replaced simply by unscrewing that little top and bottom screw. And then, and looks like mine are actually needing that here pretty soon. In fact, and I can switch that out very easily if I just grab some replacement pads there. So have a pair of those. The next thing on my list are my Zuron crimpers. So I believe, did I talk about the round nose pliers yet? I don't think I talked about the round nose. Before we move on to the crimpers, I love the tapered end on the round nose pliers. Most of my simple loops tend to go at the quarter mark on the pliers. I could mark it with a Sharpie, but I feel like I've gotten so proficient with using these that I really don't need it. Plus, if I'm trying to make a wire wrap loop that goes around, say, captor chain or pipe chain, I can move down into the larger part of my round nose pliers and make my loop there to then string over those two types of chains. So yeah, I really love these. They, again, just for their tapered tip, and I can go very small and discreet with my loops all the way to something that'll fit around my silver silk chains. So definitely have a set of those. So those are my main five Pro Line Weber's pliers that I highly recommend you guys go out and grab. Next is Zuron crimpers. I love these. They have a very tapered nose, which are great as a substitute chain nose pliers. And then they have three different crimp size settings, as you guys can see. It goes all the way to little baby crimps to larger crimp tubes that might be 3 by 3 millimeter in size. And then you've got that V-shaped divot that's traditional to a blue-handled crimper that you use in step one of crimping to separate all your different wires into the channels. I really love having these. They're a great standard pair of crimpers. I've used them as chain nose pliers before too. And so I recommend having these. They're very, very inexpensive too, by the way. So that's one type of crimpers. The other is my magical crimpers. These I got from Softflex Company. They have a single round divot that you can put your crimp tube into. And it only works with a 2 millimeter crimp tube, by the way. And whenever you use your crimp tube, you want to make sure that your crimp is stuffed with multiple beading wires in it to crimp correctly. The more it's stuffed with wires, the more round that crimp will look. So the idea for these pliers is that the crimp isn't folded. It is turned into essentially a spacer. You go in on it and you press it round and round around the crimp, and it turns it into a spacer that holds all of those wires nicely packaged inside of that crimp. You'll see me using it during videos, so don't stress about the technique. And I know Softflex Company also creates tutorials using these, so there's lots of content out there for how to use these. I also love that the ends of the crimp pliers have this flat nose, in case I'm just wanting to make a flat crimp, and there are occasions when I do. So I really love these pliers, and you just never know when I'm in the mood to use these versus the Zoron crimpers, and it really just depends on the project. Okay, so my beading awl. I love this little thing. I've had this thing for nearly 10 years as well. You can see it's sort of bent up there at the end. It's gotten a little dull over time, and I'm not mad about it because this way it's less pokey, less stabby whenever I need to get through beads, and I don't have to worry about hurting myself. But I just love this to get into tiny spaces. I've also used this to open up the knits in the knitted wire chains in case I need to sew through them, or if I'm passing some stringing wire through the knitted part of the silver silk. It comes in handy for quite a few things. So I recommend having a beading awl in your toolkit. And then we kind of move on to a whole different technique, which is bead weaving. And this is some supplies that I recommend if you are wanting to use it for bead weaving onto silver silk. And these particular supplies are very basic, I will say that. First is some tulip needles. These are Japanese needles, and they are thebomb.com. I love these. They have a gold tip. Let me see if I can bring one out. There we go. And so I haven't had one break one on me yet, which is also kind of amazing. I love how they're storage in this little tube. And I think it comes as 5 in a set, but they're great for bead weaving. They're just big enough to fit through most beads that are tiny. I typically have gotten to the point to where I don't seed bead weave under size 11 seed beads, if I can help it. Size 15 really gets to be a stretch, especially for me, because I can't see the size 15 beads anymore, or the holes in them to save my life. But, you know, for size 8 or beyond, size 8, size 11 seed beads, it's perfect for that. And to pair it with wildfire beading thread is perfect as well. It comes in different weights. There's a fine version. There's this 0.006 inch diameter, and I believe there's a 0.008 inch diameter, which is thicker. But I kind of like to just stick around the 0.006 inch diameter for my wildfire for bead weaving. It tends to be a pretty good weight, and it comes in a ton of different colors that can coordinate with your seed beads. And so I recommend grabbing some spools of that, grabbing some needles, and having it ready to go. Now, I have used other beading needles in my videos, ones that are actually from Beadalon that have a large eye, and it really just depends from project to project what you're doing. I recommend probably this tulip needle over the wide-eyed needle for bead weaving, just because it's a lot easier. The stiff needle gives it much more it makes it easier to string on the beads, to pass it through other beads, and especially whenever you're sort of wrapping up your bead weaving project, you'll want to get to a point to where you can easily sew through all of the different beads to meet your thread paths together and tie your string or whatever off. So yeah, that's why I go with the tulip needles anymore. And then finally, some chicamasa. Hopefully I said that right. And I also just add a little bit of flair to it. My thread scissors. As I sort of mentioned earlier, I have used my Lindstrom cutters to cut wildfire. But I also have these on the back end. And chicamasa, Japan. These are amazing. Japan produces a lot of great beading tools. I'll put that out there. And I definitely enjoyed these thread scissors. And I've had these since 2012, so a long time. And they have remained sharp to this day. I just use these for thread. I have cut flat mesh silver silk with it before. And so if it's just kind of soft and easy to cut, then these scissors are perfect for that. And there are a ton of different beading scissors out there that you can use, or craft scissors, but I just prefer to like have them separate from cutting other things. And that will ensure its life is going to be long lasting to the end of time. And that's sort of my like spew on tools. And you can see like, just, it's not a huge collection, but it is the most effective tool set that I've had. And I've used this for many years at this point. I only picked up the Weber set maybe in 2019, I want to say. And so it's been a little bit of time now, and I haven't really ventured too far out of my basic tool set. So when you find something good, you keep it and you share it with your friends. And so I hope this video was informational and gives you guys a starting point for where to acquire the tools, what to acquire to even start, where to acquire them, and hopefully what to do with them. And as, again, you'll see in the tutorials, you will start to see me using these different tools in the different projects that I do. So again, just bookmark this video and keep it for reference. Be sure to subscribe to the channel when you get a chance. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed learning about these different tools that I use for SilverSilk. And I'll just see you guys at the next tutorial. Bye.